Hey, y'all. Hi. It is time for me to pop in and give you a new episode of New Makeup Hot Takes. I have a lot of takes and they're hot, meaning not all of them are thorough. I'm looking at the lineup here. Yeah, it's going to be one of those ones where we bust through. Not all of these deserve more than a hot take. Not all of these deserve a take that's baked in the oven and then allowed to cool before serving. That's my feeling. If this happens to be your first time to my channel, I'm really glad that you're watching this one. My name is Hannah. I'm a writer. I will link my book down below. I also make YouTube videos about aesthetics, and I implore you, if you live in the United States, to register to vote. Now let us get into the meat of the video. New makeup, hot takes, new makeup, hot takes. Okay, here we go, here we go. Here we go. Victoria Beckham Beauty complexion product. I saw this and my first thought was Kalu Kalay. It's exciting to see Victoria Beckham come out with a complexion product, kind of the moment we've all been waiting for. The lightest shade looks incredibly light, a little bit on the yellow side, but in that sort of luminous way that I might be able to work with. Historically, I've gotten along well with this type of thing. They tend to be kind of a luminous coverage in general. All good. $68 for how much product could possibly be in this little pen. I mean, maybe it's the same amount as normal concealer. I mean, how much is in a normal thing? An ounce? All I have is the Ami Colay lip gloss, which, can we have a moment? It just always looks impeccable. 4.5 milliliters. It seems like that's probably about how much there is in here. Isn't a usual foundation like a couple of ounces? Like a bottle? We're used to getting a bottle. Here is the thing. If it's a foundation, we get a bottle of multiple, what's the word I'm looking for? Doses. Multiple doses of liquid. It's not the word I'm looking for, but I can't work it out right now. A hefty serving of liquid in a bottle, right? That's what we're used to if it's like a foundation. Some complexion products are tinier amounts, concealers, and then it's in like a little doe foot applicator thing. But then it's not $68. I think that's all I'm getting at. Cat hair right at the beginning of New Makeup Hot Takes. And a hair growing out of my chinny chin chin, but nothing with which to pluck it. Don't look too close, friends. Maybe it has nothing to do with the pen. Maybe the pen holds the same amount as a normal concealer tube. What we have here, and this is my official hot take, is Victoria Beckham giving us concealer at foundation prices, even by luxury standards. Let us move on. Natasha Denona, I need a warm palette. This, I know that I'm very word-centric. I am one of these bees who walks through a museum of painting and sculpture, making a beeline for the title, like the name of the thing. And then I look at the piece of art through the lens of what it is titled. That is very much my way of interacting, okay? So I know that I am that way. I cannot see the palette for the title, right? I cannot see past... I need a warm, which absolutely reads to me like an April Fool's joke. Like, in my universe, that is an absolute corker of an April Fool's joke. To be Natasha Denona and name your palette, I need a warm. A warm what, Natasha? Now, I don't need a warm. I prefer a heavily neutral, if not slightly cool. We're leaving off the nouns here. We're just going with adjectives. I don't need a warm. I prefer a neutral. I prefer a cool. And yet, I really love the sparkly, crushy, creamy shades in this, even the quite warm ones. Because if I'm going to use a warm, then it's going to be like a warm pinky or peachy champagne-y sparkle. It's not going to be one of these essentially orange browns. But half of this palette is orange browns, so I am not compelled to buy it. I don't desire it. I don't need a warm, and I don't need this. Rabanne blushes. Now here, oh, I should have brought it up here. You know when you are living in a chaotic mess for a long time, but you kind of know where everything is, and in a weird way, everything's always right there. Everything's around you, because here's how it's been. You know Pigpen in Charlie Brown? All of my belongings have just been swirling around me like the dirt and flies swirl around Pigpen. So a couple of days ago, at this moment in New Makeup Hot Takes, if I had been filming, I would have been able to pull the Rabanne Soul Kiss lip balm out of that miasma of swirling belongings and show it to you. And I would have been like, I have it right here. But I started cleaning up and organizing. My cousin is here. She's helping. My cousin is here. She is washing my makeup brushes. She is a tender, sweet young thing. She's like half my age, right? So it's kind of like a symbiotic relationship, right? She's here. She's living with us for a little while and she's performing acts of service. And she has helped me begin to organize things. Consequently, the poor Rabanne Soul Kiss lip balm, which is vying for the top spot of product of the year. Product of the year, y'all. It is so good. And this is the context that you need to understand with the takedown that I'm about to do to these very small blushes. That's basically the gist. I know not where it is because my cousin has helped me clean. It's probably right where it should be. And I don't know where that is. I don't know where it should be. I think it's probably just in my makeup bag, but my makeup bag is where it should be, which is not here, but where I keep it. I love that brown lip balm. These blushes, I want them to be great because I have a vested interest, right? I like this brand. So far, the one thing I've tried, very impressed. It just looks all wrong. They look absolutely tiny. They look a bit drugstore to me. The colors, I guess, are fine, but there isn't one of these palettes that is the one that I would design for myself, right? There's not a pale, extremely neutral, kind of greenish grayish with a really washed out ballerina pink highlight. The pans look tiny and the shape of the compacts is weird when the lid is open, which is how it is in these images. It looks kind of like a pair of binoculars looking at you. And I just don't understand why. I don't know why this is the shape of the packaging. I don't know why they're so tiny. I don't know why they went with these colors. And I don't really know what the formula is like based on any of this advertising imagery. So a swing and a miss from Rabanne, IMHO. Givenchy. Why did I put this in here? I composed this list of things to discuss a few days ago, and I had really good reasons for all of them, and most of them I remember. And this one, I think it was just to say, oh, I do remember. This is a holiday preview. I think that I wanted to say two things. One, weirdly, okay, so it's August as I sit here, probably September as you sit there. It doesn't feel too soon to me. I don't know if I've just been in this job for too long, but I'm like, oh yeah, this is hitting right. It's time to start thinking about holiday. Maybe I'm just excited. Like I'm ready in a weird way for the holiday season. Maybe I'm ready for change. I don't know. Maybe that's why they do it. Maybe that's why they start publishing holiday releases so early, because then you get to be the one who generates that very first thrill of anticipation for fall, for the winter, for the holiday season. So that's one reason that I pulled this to talk about, because I saw it and I was like, oh yeah, holiday season right around the corner, which is by all definitions an absolutely bananas thing to say and think. And then my other thought about this is, are we going down this path of neutrals with a red lip with blue eyeshadow? Is that what holiday makeup is going to be this year? I actually am completely remembering my entire thesis that I had when I saw this first, and I plan to talk about it. I anticipate the holiday season with some pleasure. I anticipate finding out what the color trends are going to be. That's why I saw this and I was like, this can't be it. It can't be pop of blue. We are not doing pop of blue for holiday 2024, but what are we doing? I'm so curious. I can't wait to find out. It's probably not going to be this, Givenchy. Nice try. That's kind of how I feel. Okay, Dolly Parton. Everything about this is so iconic. Mostly that they used this image, which is it a retro image of her or is it recent and she did a photo shoot that's styled to look? Cannot be, but one cannot tell. That's what it is. No, this must be from when this is what we love about Dolly Parton. Have you heard that thing about, it's like an urban myth that she's absolutely covered with tattoos from the neck down all over her arms and legs and that she just always wears basically a bodysuit to cover it all up so that nobody knows. Dolly Parton, drag queen and national treasure. I live for her. I probably won't be buying any of these. I mean, you know, my favorite people, my favorite like celebrities and international, what are they called? Intellectual properties and stuff have released makeup and it doesn't really compel me unless the makeup itself does. You know, I'm not out here trying to get a piece of the Dolly Parton pie. Like I can appreciate her just as much not buying the lipstick. It's just not the way that I consume. It's just nice to see her here in the makeup space and her rhinestone covered lipstick cases. And you know, the thing about Dolly Parton is that she is an absolute master of distributing her wealth. She's just made such amazing choices in terms of the foundations she founds and the causes that she supports. She's just incredible. So probably if you buy a lipstick, it's going to a good cause, a Dolly Parton lipstick. But even that is not enough to compel me. I'm just here to say, go Dolly, go. Okay, here we've reached the heart of the video. A string of absolutely unhinged scent releases, like questionable scent releases. First, I need to say, I do feel like this is a bit of a response to or an imitation of the sniff scent Crumb, which what I'm looking at here, the first one in the lineup that we're about to skate through, is this Auntie Anne's pretzel collab, scent collab. Each spritz evokes the experience of passing an Auntie Anne's store and inhaling the nostalgic aroma of their pretzels. And yes, that is a scent that many of us have positive memories of. It is nostalgic. It's like late 90s, early 2000s childhood when you go to the mall. Like, that's the vibe. Maybe even past that when you go to the mall in your childhood if you're younger than that, because there's still Auntie Anne's out there. Maybe you're not even a child and you're at the mall and you're smelling the smell. I mean, I think it's a thing. It's a good smell. It's a smell that makes us want to eat pretzels. Is it a smell you want coming from your own body? No. I actually think no. The description goes on to say, the new scent will make you think you're smothering yourself in a warm, freshly made pretzel. Do you want to smother yourself in a warm, freshly made pretzel? No, I think no. I mean, maybe you, I don't want to speak for you, but it seems like quite the novelty item to me. However, I do want to say that Crumb, which is the croissant scent by Sniff, is amazing. Sniff sent it to me. It is so beautiful. The bottle is so beautiful. I showed it to my cousin, my aforementioned cousin, this morning. She immediately sprayed it upon her person, and she has smelled amazing all day. I'm a little bit still dancing around on the outskirts of scent these days because my sense of smell is still sort of recovering. My hormones are still kind of settling, but I'm starting to get it back. I'm starting to get back to like a normal relationship with scent. And oh my gosh, that stuff is amazing. So when I saw this, I was like, and then I was like, well, and then I read the description and I was like, I don't think so. Moving on, Fleur, heavy cream. Once again, cream goes sour. That's the thing. Cream, like a dairy product, just a pure dairy product. And it does make you feel like you're just spraying cream out of a diffuser. Clearly, it's going to be a more complex scent than just the smell of heavy cream, but it makes it seem like it will literally go sour on your body, because if you put heavy cream upon your wrists, you know, it wouldn't smell good by the afternoon. It's hard to get into it. It's hard to get behind it. I also think, even though it's not that, even though I can see that I'm having that reaction where I'm like, ew, heavy cream, ew, and then recognize that that's not actually what it's going to smell like. It's just going to be a perfume and that that's just marketing. Even then, I suspect I won't love the scent. It seems like it will be very sweet and cloying, a milky impression of decadent sweetness, you know, milky, sweet, too much for me. I already just feel like this is too much for me. And I speak as someone who has been enjoying the croissant smell all day. Third in the lineup, the scent lineup today, Fefe. A scent for dogs. The thing that's funny to me about this is that seeing it advertised, just Trend Mood, she just pumps them out. She just gets a thing that she is gonna post and she just makes a post. And it's always like, rare, like five alarm fire, alert, alert, new, this, da da da. It's like, did you get yours? Like, it's always the same language. And so when there's something silly like this and she just like plugs it into the formula and spits it out, it just tickles me, right? It just tickles me. Available now. Siren emoji. New. Fragrance for dogs. Paw print emoji. Heart, heart. Sparkle. Fei Fei. Hashtag Dolce & Gabbana. Like, and it's just, there's no sense of irony. Like, there is no sense. There is no wink, wink, nudge, nudge about the irony in which this release, to me, is clearly steeped. Fragrance mist for dogs, housed in a sleek green lacquered glass bottle adorned with a vibrant red metal cap and a precious 24-karat gold-plated paw print. Let's be specific. It's not a paw there, it's a paw print. A 24-karat plated gold paw would be like a paw coming out of, like the lid would be a paw reaching. I would be a bit more avant-garde. Touch of musk, woody, creamy undertones. I mean, I'm kind of here for it. Probably smells amazing. It's just, I think that it is the relationship to irony and the lack thereof that gets me about this and the announcement about it. And I was already like, pretzel-scented perfume, really? Heavy cream, really? And then it was like, fragrance for dogs. And, you know, this is slightly less absurd, but Replica, Afternoon Delight. I think I just already had it in my mind that we had, like, flipped into a scent alternate universe and everything was absurd. And I saw that and I could only think of that scene in Arrested Development where Michael and Mabee are singing. Isn't the song called Afternoon Delight? Like a performance of that. And it's really awkward. And I was just like, Replica, maybe should have workshopped that a little longer. And then here we have the least absurd at all. These Valentino scent bottles. I just included this because here's what happened. I think this is the total takeaway. I was going through scent listing after scent announcement on Trend Mood. They were getting increasingly more absurd, increasingly more surreal. And then by the end of it, I was like, I want perfume. I want to buy perfume. And I saw this Valentino advertisement. And I was like, wow, those bottles look incredibly gorgeous. I would totally get that, which I wouldn't, you know, I'm not going to. I loved the way they looked so much. And I felt like scent was so exciting that I put it on here to talk about, even though there's nothing to say about this except Valentino also is releasing perfume. The advertising worked on me even though it's so weird. It's just good to be aware. You know, it's good to like keep an eye on yourself, especially when a trend in advertising or a trend in products is like getting in amongst you despite yourself. So we're not buying scent. We're looking at scent. We're rolling our eyes at scent. We're not buying scent today. We are demurely refraining from making a purchase, a scent purchase. We're even giving our free bottle of scent away to our cousin. Let's move on. Rode. Okay, I was supposed to film the Rode video today. I tried everything from Rode. I have a lot to say. I think I want my thoughts to be very organized, and I had prepared this video already, so that's why I decided to do this instead, because I didn't have time to both organize my thoughts and film. And for this video, I had already organized my thoughts, so now we're filming. But next up, I think, is going to be the Rode video. Stay tuned. I mean, not to spoil it, but the blush is really good, and everyone I know seems to be taking an interest. I'm getting texts from friends who like live across the country who I haven't talked to in a while. And they're like, is the Rode blush good? Texting me. And my cousin showed up on the doorstep. And she's like, hi, so good to see you. Is the Rode blush good? It is. It is so good. I'm wearing it today. The one I got is the shade Sleepy Girl. I'm wearing it today and I have a lot to say. And when I saw this, this is a new shade of the Pocket Blush. Pearly. It's a whirl. A worm. It's not a worm. The new Pocket Blush by Rode in the shade Worm. A worm pearly pink. A worm pearly pink shade. It says it's a warm pearly pink shade that you can only pick up at our New York City pop-up. It's probably going to go online at some point. It's a worm that you can only pick up at the New York City pop-up. That's fine because I don't want a warm pink blush. I don't want worm. I do like the pearly thing, but the thing that's so amazing about the one that I have. It's not pearly, but it has this ineffable sheen. So I kind of prefer that actually. Maybe a pearly version of the Rode blush would defeat some of what it has going for it. So I can leave this one. However, it already says available August 1st on their website. Oh my gosh, that was a month ago. I am so behind in the beauty space. Old news, my friends. I'm just intrigued. I am following Rode with great interest now, in spite of my past self. I'm following the future career of the Pocket Blush, and I'm curious to know what other shades they might consider releasing. Okay, moving on. Guerlain x Pucci? Some sort of fashion collab. It says featuring Marmo print details. It's just stunning. It is just beautiful objects. The design. The execution, the irreverence, the luxury, the cohesion, the concept, the fact that they didn't try to do too much of everything, but that they did so much in one direction. It is perfectly balanced. This is how we do it. You know, if you're trying to do something like this, this is how it's done. This is what I feel. This is how it's done. Even the colors of the palette are so weird and so aligned with the packaging and the overall concept. Purple, black, white, and red. I don't know who's into this. Like, I'm not needing to buy this. I'm not really a collector in this way. I'm sure there's an audience, but that's not really what I'm about here with this kind of thing. It's just like something you'd see in a museum and you'd be like, wow, cool. Like a museum of product design. We're in a PowerPoint presentation about product design, you know, and you'd be like, wow, I really liked that one. Very memorable. A very good example of the craft. I like it and not buy it. And that's what I'm going to do. Okay, next up. I like to dislike it and not buy it. I should have grouped this together with the pretzel scent. Chipotle makeup. There are pros and cons here, okay? The con is that it's Chipotle makeup. So it's like guacamole themed. Yeah, it's just, it's green. Oh, I see. It's a green foil lip treatment that peels off to reveal a rosy nude stain. It's like a weird kind of makeup from Wonder Skin, like semi-permanent makeup. That's already not compelling to me. And it's, you know, Chipotle themed, which is just, it's mixing pleasures in my mind and they like cancel each other out, mixing Chipotle with lipstick. On the plus side, they called it Lipotle. Lipotle. They're like, let's call it Lipotle. And everyone in the boardroom was like, oh, definitely that. Nothing could possibly be better. We're going with Lipotle. And thirdly, weirdly, when I look at this piece of advertising, the napkins in the top left corner make the shape of a house, like the outline of like a child's drawing of a house. And that's all I can see. When I look at this, I just see a house, a napkin house floating in space above these models modeling Lipotle. Oh my gosh, we have to talk about the re-release of the original Urban Decay Naked palette, which they sent me. I should have it here and I don't. I opened the box, looked at it. I have it, it's in the next room. I looked at it and I had a good laugh because do you remember the drama that was the discontinuing of this product? The brand generated empty drama that even influencers' best attempts, which were considerable, failed to properly stoke. The spectacular failure to generate passion for the discontinuing of this product that occurred when they discontinued it. Do you remember they had like a funeral with a casket or something? I think I was already filming New Makeup Hot Takes at the time. And if I was, what I said was they're definitely going to re-release it at some point in the future. And here we are 5 years later. I mean, it can't be more than 4 or 5 years later. Back by popular demand, the iconic 12 neutral eyeshadows in ultra smooth mattes. Are they though? Because here's the thing about Urban Decay Naked. Eyeshadow has evolved since this day. It was the first palette for all intents and purposes. It wasn't really, but for all intents and purposes, it was both Adam and Eve. It was the first, the original, the seed from which all palettes sprung. Palettes have gotten better since Urban Decay formulated eyeshadows on that fateful day at the beginning of time, like the big bang of eyeshadow palettes. So they've continued to make naked palettes with the same formula, and they're fine if you want just like a barely there wash of color. But I feel like anybody who's into makeup enough to be nostalgic enough to buy this for the sake of nostalgia, we now also have tried like some indie eyeshadows, maybe even Tasha Denona, Pat McGrath eyeshadows. And we're like, where is the pigment? Where is the manipulability? Where is the payoff? I speak as someone who has not yet messed with the one they sent. I don't know if it merits an entire video unless you want to see that, unless you want to see me reviewing like the re-release of the Naked palette announced 4 weeks ago, and it's probably already sold out. So probably not. I've just tried a lot of Naked palettes in my day. Other Naked, Naked Cowgirl or like Naked Spaceman or Naked Dancer or whatever. I mean, haven't there been Naked like Deep Sea Diver? And all of them were weak. So I will be surprised if this one isn't. Another throwback, the Too Faced Appley in Love. Is it really called Appley? Oh, Happily in Love. It took me a long time to get the pun. I was like, Appley? Who is Appley? Appley in Love? It's sort of giving because they just have never moved on. It's sort of giving. Apple-inspired palette. It just looks exactly the same as like the Sweet Peach palette, pretty much in every way. I mean, if you change the packaging to the Sweet Peach palette and you're like, this is what it looked like, I would be like, I vaguely remember it being a little more orange, but I would probably just think I was remembering wrong. Like, it really looks like everything they ever did back in the day. There are some things about which I have a long memory. And I look at this and I just think about that cake. Can't let it go. So I don't really have much time for it. But since we were already talking about nostalgic eyeshadow palettes, I had to just throw this one up here right after the Naked palette. They are totally peas in a pod. From a place of more neutrality, because I haven't even said anything about the palette itself and the colors. And I don't like it. Warm browns, a green. The swatches look dusty. Absolutely not. But it's just, that's not what it's about for me. It's just more like, oh, that old thing. Okay. let's get serious, friends. Prada green color corrector and Prada green powder. Is that it? Is there something else? Yeah, that's it. The setting powder is $90. It's about to be a new month. You know, I have a monthly budget for reviewing products. I don't know if I can even justify spending that much on a product like this for the sake of review. Because even if it's the greatest powder in the world, and I'm like, it's amazing, it's a game changer for people with redness, like who among you is going to go out and then buy it for $90? It's good to know that something can still make my wretched, aged, jaded little makeup-loving heart double beat, right? It's good to know that the same person who mere minutes ago was like, all naked palettes are garbage. Toothpaste is garbage. These eyeshadows look dusty. Nothing is good anymore. Can also be like, I want this $90 green setting powder from Prada. And I'm feeling like a little bit of hyperventilation over it. You know, like it's good to feel those feelings. And I think for now, we're going to leave it at that. This is the kind of thing that I know better than to immediately act on this passion. I will probably wake up a couple of mornings from now and be like, oh, I'm absolutely not. Whoever thought she needed that, you know, it'll probably just go away. Or a week from now, I will still want it and maybe I'll get it for review. And maybe there will be a lot of you in the comments who are like, I actually am a candidate for the purchase of this product and I do need you to review it. Because if anyone is capable of giving a thorough, relevant, fair review of a green Prada setting powder and primer, I am she. Okay, not much needs to be said about this Real Techniques blending sponge with the fingerprints. This is my hot, steaming hot take, strongly suspect this of being something that they made just to generate chatter. Like, Real Techniques, hasn't their star kind of waned a little bit just as a brand, like as brands go? We're not talking about Real Techniques as much as we once did, but now we are because they made a sponge, a makeup sponge, that's supposed to mimic the application done with your fingers. And it just... let's all say it together. Why don't you just use your fingers? They're right there. I mean, it's so silly. I'm going to scroll down and look at the first comment. And I bet it's going to say, why don't you just use your fingers? Oh, it's the third comment down. Why not use your fingers? The other ones are just much more sour, mean, bitter, Betty, angry for this. Like, just the comments on trend mood. They make me want to crawl back under my rock. Anyway, nobody needs this. Let's move on. Hermes makeup. So beautiful. It's just so beautiful. Look at the palette. I don't need a palette of four eyeshadows, one of which is peach, which I don't like wearing as an eyeshadow. Another of which is green, which I also don't like wearing as an eyeshadow. And a third of which is blue, which I don't like wearing. I actually don't like any of those four colors because the pale champagne probably not either. But I see it and I want it. I look at it. I love it the way that it looks. I love it. These just are truly works of art. Again, like the Guerlain. It's interesting to see luxury makeup brands like Guerlain, like the holiday collection that we saw earlier that just looked, compared to this, so dated. And even compared to Prada's branding, that looked honestly like 10 years old. It's cool to see some other luxury fashion houses stepping up, starting makeup brands, and then slaying the game with packaging and design. It's just cool. Again, not cool to the tune of the many, many dollars I would be spending if I bought this. Then it's just makeup. You know what I mean? You buy it, use it, and it's just makeup. And I already have makeup, but it's just cool to see. YSL, I don't need to talk about this. It's the YSL... I saw it and I was like, it's cute and also looks weirdly dated and it looks like Little Mermaid themed and it also looks a little bit like Anastasia Beverly Hills 2016. But I'm also proud of them for breaking their mold a little bit. But also, who wants this? I don't know. Not me. Not anyone I can think of. It's just weird. Like, what? It seems like weird, out of space, out of time, out of touch. When you're looking at these fashion house makeup brands, high fashion luxury makeup brands, some girls got it, some girls don't. All right, let's just knock out these last couple. Fenty Black Lip Luminizer, coming for my wig. I want this. I love a sheer black lip with a slightly pink sparkle. I think that's all I have to say. It's gonna go on my Christmas wish list. And lastly, Gucci. Interesting. I should have grouped them all together. I think it turned out that in this video, there are a lot of luxury makeup brands, fashion-based, and half of them, I feel, are dropping the ball, and half of them have picked up that ball. Generally, I feel like Gucci has the ball firmly in its chipped red nail polish, high shine flash photography photographed grip. This is a bit of a more run-of-the-mill release, the new Glow Powder Gel Highlighter. I usually want everything that Gucci makes. And this, I'm not as big of a fan of the compact. It just doesn't look as covetable, as retro. It doesn't look heavy. Maybe it is, but it doesn't look as dreamy as the other Gucci packaging that I've fallen for. It doesn't make me want it. And also, this is why I really put this up to talk about. Powder gel highlight. I think that's just a powder. And they're calling it powder gel. And this doesn't just apply to Gucci, but all the makeup brands. All these makeup brands are out here saying powder to gel, powder to cream. And then it's, you get it and it's just a powder. And it might be a slightly, ever so slightly creamy powder, but really, this is the thing that they're doing. If you are trying to sell me a highlighter and you're like, it's a powder, I don't want it. If you are trying to sell me a highlighter and you're like, it's a gel, I might want it. It's a cream, I probably want it. And I think I speak for all of us. I know I don't. I know there's some of you out there who want it, a powder, okay? But I think I speak for many of us. I feel I am the voice of my generation when I say that. I think the brands know that. So they're like, let's come up with a powder highlight. We've been designing this powder highlight. We want to sell it. We want to make money. And then they're like, well, in order to do that, we're going to have to say that it's a liquid when in fact it's a solid. We're going to have to say that it's a gel when in fact it's a powder. So let's call it powder gel. It's like the Emperor's New Clothes, but nobody's pointed it out yet until today. You're welcome. Let's end the video. That is the end. Those are my hot takes. Thank you for being here and watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for the road video that's coming soon. Don't forget to register to vote, and don't forget to take extra good care of yourself so that you can be the most effective version of yourself as you do your work in the world.